is to keep still.
I know it's a little long on the song, but I always feel like I like ending at that, bit of verbiage, that will be done. Because, man, I'm just seeking His will right now, and I don't know what it is. Man, I've been praying for healing for a while and being prayed for healing. And listen, that's happened before in my life and worked. It got rid of Kawasaki disease. Look it up. And ulcerative colitis as well. Just miraculous healing just by praying to the Most High. Those are just a couple of the ways He chose to reveal Himself to me, and I don't know why still. I still don't know why I was plucked from the journey to hellfire, so to speak, but I was, and I don't know why my stupid eye. It's such a little thing, and it's so funny. Throughout much of my life, little things are those that bother me the most. Little things tend to be the things that would make me lose my temper and flip my wig, you know? Traffic was huge in that. It's just small things. It's like little things. It's a small disrespect. It's always just like... Or the other day, I couldn't get into this, I was meeting friends at this place, the Edison, and I dressed up for, it was Soup Kitchen Fridays, and I dressed up, like, for a soup kitchen, a suit and tie, and these linen pants I cut the bottoms off of to, you know, as though I've been walking it all day long, trying to find a job, and they didn't want to let me in, because they said they were shorts, and I was, like, immediately filled with so much rage. It's little things like that. It's just little, petty, silly things that make me the most angry, that make me murder people in my heart, that make me sin. So, and it's funny, in His word He says, you know, if your right eye causes you to sin, it's better for you to pluck it out than for it to lead you to the day of judgment, so to speak. I'm gonna keep saying so to speak, I don't know why. So I don't know if this eye has been causing me to sin or something. So, I don't know, I've just been praying for peace, you know, and just to, and I know it's been starting to affect my mood, you know, because everything you see is blurry, and it's just constantly irritating, and I'm doing this, and I can't put contacts on, so I can't do a bunch of other things that, like, help me get my energy out, and or I can't do them as full of vigor if I'm wearing spectacles, because spectacles go flying off, and smashing up, and so forth. Can't do Krav at all, which gets out so much of my, like, the temper in my body, and so it's been really hard to control anger, not having that relief valve, or release valve, and so I just prayed this morning. I've been praying every day for healing, and then I've been praying for just healing in my soul, man. If there's a lesson somehow in this, and I just wanna, I felt kind of negative yesterday. I was very easy. I don't know. I was very trapped in my old ways a little bit yesterday, and I've just been asking God to deliver me not only from the affliction of this stupid eye thing, but then the affliction of my soul, man, that never goes away, and just to help me remain in his sight, in His joy, just still make me more and more like Him, more and more like His Son, and just make me the joy of His heart, regardless of whether I'm at full strength or not, you know? That some minor affliction is no excuse to sin, but, you know, there's this dude that runs around with no arms and no legs and preaches, was born that way and preaches the good word and keeps the joy of Christ in his heart every day. So who am I to complain, A? And B, I don't know, that's my goal. That's my life's work, you know? I mean, I often think of acting and creating as my life's work, and that's the stuff my eye is running afoul of. But my life's work is to be God's child and to speak his truth and to just spread the good news that the creator of the universe wants to have a love relationship with you, with me, with you, with you, with you, with you, with you, with you, with you. Man, that's the best news ever. So that's my duty. So I'm doing my duty this morning, and I'm trying to do it in joy and not in frustration. And I wanted to pray along with David this morning, and in Psalm 51. If anyone out there is feeling separate from God or lost, man, he wants to find you. And so if you want, you can pray along with me. Friends and strangers, pray along with me. Psalm 51, verse 1. Have mercy upon me, O God, according to your loving kindness, according to the multitude of your tender mercies. Blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sin is always before me. Against you, you only have I sinned, and done this evil in your sight, that you may be found just when you speak, and blameless when you judge. Behold, I was brought forth in iniquity, and in sin my mother conceived me. Behold, you desire truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden part you will make me to know wisdom. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Make me hear joy and gladness, that the bones you have broken may rejoice. Hide your face from my sins, and blot out my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Man, I need that today. I need a clean heart and renewing of a steadfast spirit, I'll tell you that much. Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, yes please, and uphold me by your generous spirit. Then I will teach transgressors your ways, and sinners shall be converted to you. Deliver me from the guilt of bloodshed, O God, the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing aloud of your righteousness. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall show forth your praise. For you do not desire sacrifice, or else I would give it. You do not delight in burnt offering. The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart. These, O God, you will not despise. So I'm just seeking anew the love of the Lord today, and I had one other thing I wanted to read, and I will sign off and let you have your day. But that prayer is great, by the way. If ever you're like, all right, even if I buy all this stuff that this dude is spitting, how do I have any relationship to it? Man, that prayer right there is pretty close to everything you need to say. Say it in your heart, say it in your soul, and just walk in the joy of the Lord. Man, it has changed my life. It is the best thing, period, that has ever happened to me. Hebrews 4:14. Seeing then that we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast our confession. For we did not have a high priest who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses, but was in all points tempted as we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. That's all I need this morning, grace and mercy to help in my time of need. And if Christ, in the afflictions he suffered on this earth, all the whips and spitting in the eye and so forth, he was disrespected beyond disrespect and wounded beyond wounding, and yet he sinned not. I've just been asking for help, man, to just push through what I'm dealing with and sin not, but let the joy of the Lord be my strength. Amen.